What's going on, guys? We may be headed to a second lockdown. Right now, the pandemic is surging. We're reaching in epidemic levels in Texas, El Paso. It is said that El Paso is worse than New York was. And we're not even fully in winter yet. So I feel that we're gonna have a second lockdown that's gonna be much more strict and stringent than the last one. However, there's gonna be a few hiccups because Biden is gonna get in office. I don't care what Trump's doing. Trump's just gonna have to accept the fact that he lost. And they're gonna try to get some money to the people for this 4 to 6 week lockdown. I really feel it's coming because today, Alabama was supposed to play LSU, but so many LSU players are sick, they couldn't play. And that game's been postponed. And I've been seeing this over and over and over with college football. I'm starting to see it with the NFL, and we're not fully cold yet. We haven't hit flu, you know, we're about to enter in the flu season. So honestly, I'm thinking about having my assistants move in. If we go to a full lockdown, I'm just like, look, you know, you can move in so we can still keep working. We still keep doing what we need to do. I'm just thinking of the future because it may not happen, but based upon the surge in corona cases and looking at what has happened, because with countries that fully lock down, because like I said, we are Americans. Nobody tells us what to do. I'm gonna go to this Halloween party. I'm gonna go to this football game. I'm gonna go out and live my life. And this is where people have been. But now what is happening is, because I don't know what's happening in New York, but the medical community is starting to be stressed the hell out, and the resources and stuff. And they're, you know, a nurse in Houston, well, El Paso, she did a video talking about that the hospitals weren't doing enough to save these people, and all these people were coding. I personally, and this is something that I saw, I personally know people who have COVID. Before November, I didn't know anyone that had COVID. I had heard of people, but I actually know, well, October, that's not true. I knew someone in October. But now I know multiple people who have COVID. And many of us as Americans are going to be able to say we now know someone who has it or had it or passed from it. Now, one of the things that, you know, we got to do, because I really feel that this is coming. I feel that they're going to do it. I feel that we're going to have a very strict lockdown that's going to come from the federal level, because with Trump, we never got that. We got guidelines, but Trump was kind of like fighting with Dr. Fauci. And I feel that this time is going to be radically different because we're going to have a president that's going to want to embrace a lockdown to keep people safe. And we're not going to be out of this until we get a vaccine. And let's talk about the vaccine. There are people already declared vaccine come out. I ain't taking it. So we've got that issue. And once again, 2021 is going to be a bad year. This is one of the reasons that I'm loading up on cash. You know, many people are like, oh, cash, invest in the stock market. If Biden gets in office and Biden recommends a real strict lockdown, it's going to crash the stock market. So for those of you who are waiting on some deals, they're coming. Like I said, I predicted in my live streams that the stock market was going to crash. It was going to go up. It's going to go down. It's going to go up. It's going to go down. It's going to go up. We'll see what it does to Bitcoin. Also, with that, you know, I give a lot of advice on this channel, and I've been on you guys to start businesses, start side hustles for 11 years. But when I say don't buy Bitcoin, that's the only thing you hear. Let me tell you something, and I'm gonna be really clear, and I wanna be articulate to you. If you're buying Bitcoin at its current price, you don't have the economic ability to buy enough Bitcoin to make a big difference in your life. If you had got in when I got in and then, you know, it was like 80 cents a coin, okay, you could have loaded up. Honestly, I wish I had bought more back then, but who's to predict the future? So all you Bitcoin bulls, like I'm buying Bitcoin, do you have a car payment? Do you have credit card debt? Do you have a savings fund? Do you have an emergency fund? Do you have any of that? Because if you don't, but you're buying Bitcoin, you're financially stupid. You're financially stupid. I'm not messing with no Bitcoin. Not right now. I don't care if it gets to $1 million a coin. I'm not messing with it because I have a financial device that makes me money. So I'm not messing with it. But if we have a second federally mandated lockdown, this is going to cause a lot of problems. Layoffs are going to go back up. Unemployment, because essentially we're going to see what happens. I'm going to report back on this and what's possibly going to happen, what is possibly coming. But we will see in January. We'll see January to February what's going to happen. And right now, the recommendation is don't get together for Thanksgiving. This is what's being put out. Just have a virtual Thanksgiving, see your people, because we're in for another very, very tough 6 to 9 months until vaccine comes out. And then when the vaccine comes out, there are some people that it's not going to work for. So one of the things that you've got to understand and look at, and hopefully you're battening down your hatches, because if we go through another lockdown, this is going to push the housing crisis either further out, because what they're going to do is federally mandate that you can't evict anyone, federally mandate that you can't foreclose on anyone, and they may make it for the whole 2021. So what we're going to have is all of this pent up activity of evictions and landlords and people having houses. It's going to be a mess. It is going to be an absolute mess. And, you know, I'm just looking because I'm checking the market. Like right now, the market's white hot. I mean, people are fighting over houses. They're trying to get what they can get. But going forward, once, you know, because 2021, you know, we got to see what happens, because right now we're having a record number of caseloads daily, and it's going up. It's not going down, because, you know, it kind of plateaued when we were doing most of the lockdown. And people have fatigue. They have the plague fatigue. They're just tired of it. They want to go out, live their lives, visit their friends, meet new people, do what they want to do. And it's going to be interesting. It's going to be interesting. Are we going to have a lockdown like New Zealand? Are we going to have a lockdown like France? Are we going to have a lockdown like Asia? Like in France, like if you went out, the police would stop you and ask you what you're doing out. Are we going to have one of those kind of lockdowns? I don't know. I really don't know. But I have a strong suspicion that it's coming, and it's going to impact and hit all of us. It's going to hit all of us. And one of the things that I want you guys to understand and want you guys to appreciate is, if you're not thinking about starting an internet-based business or a business with a strong internet presence, you are missing the boat, because we're going to see what's going to be left out of the lockdown, because grocery store personnel, people working grocery stores, they're going to be deemed essential. Hospital workers are going to be deemed essential. Police, firefighters going to be deemed essential. But I think, you know, we're going to see what's going to happen, because it's kind of scary. It's really scary what is on the horizon, because if the caseloads don't start going down, we're surely headed to another lockdown. And we know what the first one, and see, this is the thing. The first lockdown wasn't a full lockdown. I'm in Georgia, people are like, deuces, I'm doing what I'm doing. People in Texas, they never stayed inside. And I feel, because like I said, I personally know people with the bug. And as more people begin to know people and more people begin to see people die, this is going to have a dynamic impact on their behavior. Because I don't really have a crystal ball. This is just an educated guess that we're heading toward a second lockdown. But the second lockdown is going to, because let's look at what happened. The first lockdown wasn't a federally mandated lockdown. It was state by state. New York probably had the most strictest lockdown because they were hit the hardest. But this one's going to be different. It's going to be really different, and it's going to be more impactful. And this just got me thinking what I can do for my business, because essentially, if you don't have an internet business during this mess, I mean, I've been on record. I'm making more money than I've ever made in my life. And it's because of the lockdowns and the COVID and the pandemic. And that's what, because people are like, man, I need to start a business. This dude's talking about starting businesses. He's talking about structure. I need to start a business. And I was at the bank the other day closing the account, and the banker told me this, that when they were giving out the PPP money and the EDIL loans and stuff, she said they were opening up business accounts left and right because people were trying to get that money. She said she had never opened up so many business accounts. So this is where people are going. People are moving toward businesses. People are moving toward creating their own economies. And next year is going to be a bear. Next year is going to be rough. It's going to be rough. And I hope we don't have a second lockdown, but just reading the tea leaves, that's kind of where we're headed. And it's going to be bad. And reporting from Sugar Baby Avenue, the number of women on this site has dramatically increased. And I take that as a signal that the economy is still deteriorating. Because I'm like, because you know, when I first got on there, I was gonna do some research, I was gonna create a course for the fellas. But when I got into it and I just saw how insidious it was and how much, I was like, I'm not leading my folks down this path. I recommend that you don't become a sugar daddy. Don't even get involved in this mess because it is a dumpster fire. But now my research is different because one of the things I'm doing is contacting these chicks. I'm talking to them and I'm asking them questions. I'm doing like surveys and stuff and I'm getting some really good economic data. I'm gonna tell you that many of these women are in dire straits. They're almost hopeless. I was talking to a girl, she broke up with her dude. She moved in with her sister. She's been sleeping on the sofa for 4 months. She's in the house with her sister, her husband, their two children, her daughter, and that's been her life for 4 months. And then her car engine blew up, and I'm just sitting here just listening to these stories. Some of these stories are heartbreaking. Some of these stories are tragic. And this is a common theme because, like, I'll talk to them and, you know, we'll get into it. And because I was like, why are you on the site? That's one of my biggest questions. And also getting some intel about the men on the site. There are a lot of lonely old men because I've been talking to women and they've been telling me like, this dude 60, 65, 70 years old, 74. And these girls are like 20, 30. That's just too far a bridge for them to gap. They just can't do it. They're like, and one told me, so I was thinking, oh, you know, I saw him and he had all these wrinkles and wrinkly hands. And it made my skin crawl just to think about this dude touching me. So once again, it's a dumpster fire. It is many, many things that are going on with that. But my research is more economic based now because I'll ask him, why are you on here? How long you've been on here? Have you found a sugar daddy? Have you met anyone? And there many of them, like I've actually had lunch with four of them because we've become friends in a strange way because, you know, I'm not giving them any money and they're not giving me any sex, but we talk and we communicate. So we've become friends in some sense. And the stories, man, the stories are just like, this is an option of last resort for many women. There are many women who were living their life before the pandemic hit. They were doing what they were doing and they never would have thought about doing this, but now they are. And one of the things that's pumping them up is these women on TikTok and these women on YouTube who have these channels talking about you can be a sugar baby and you can get all this money for doing little or nothing. And they're doing it, in my opinion, for the views, because who doesn't want to get $250 for going on a dinner date and sitting down for 2 hours and eating a nice meal and getting paid for it? Who doesn't want to do that? And this is, they're lying to these chicks, because I've actually talked to some real sugar babies who've had experience, and they said, any man that wants to have sex is going to want to have sex, and if they don't want to have sex, you're not getting any money. The ones I've talked to, and one actually pointed me to the videos on YouTube and TikTok, because I didn't even know they existed, and she said, they're just gassing these girls' heads up, because they're, and also the math. Here's the thing, the number of sugar babies is like this, right? The number of men capable of being a sugar daddy are like that. So there's a very limited supply of men capable of being a sugar daddy. And the supply is just expanding, expanding, expanding. And there's a lot of desperation in that supply chain. So these chicks who want $1,500, $2,000, they're going to be outmarketed by the chicks who are gonna do it for $100. Because there was a girl who did a video and talking about, you know, the power that women have because of the ya-ya and all this other stuff. And essentially for a man like me, like, you know, I'll go into a little personal. With me and my ex, you know, she was my girlfriend. I was paying her bills when she lost her job, no problem. But she became fucking annoying. And, you know, she wanted to have sex when I was working because she didn't have shit to do. She didn't have nothing to do. And she was trying to impede on what I was doing. And I got to a point where I was like, you gotta go. So I used that as an example that, you know, my ex, she's beautiful. The sex was amazing. But men like me need more. We need companionship. We need appreciation. We need more. And like I said, she's a pretty girl. Sex was amazing. That wasn't enough to keep me engaged. I got rid of her. So for all you wannabe sugar babies out there who want a high caliber, high value man, you need to bring more to the table than your yaya. I know that these girls here on YouTube have got you gassed up. Like, I'm the type of dude you're looking for. And I'm telling you, most of you could not get me because you don't come to the table with enough substance. You don't come to the table with enough compassion. Your communication skills are absolutely deplorable. You feel that you can just show up, be cute, and some dude's gonna give you money. It ain't working like that. I'm here to tell you, reporting from Sugar Baby Avenue, it ain't like that. Because I'm here to tell you what you're competing against. Like, if you've got a really high price, like you want $500, $1,000, I'm here to tell you there are girls on there who will do it for $75. So this is who you're competing with. Once again, there are women on there that will do it for $50 and $75 because they are that out of sorts. They're that pressed for money. Like, one of my favorite things to do is to make a lowball offer to see what the chick will do. And most of the time, the initial response is, no, I can't do it. Cool, good luck, God bless you, have a nice life. Then a week or two, they circle back. They circle back, y'all. You know why they circle back? Because there are not a lot of men on the site with money. They circle back because most of these guys are playing games. Most of these guys just got enough money to pull the trigger once. And these girls are looking for an ongoing situation. And I'm here to tell you, it's gonna be hard. So if you got sugar baby visions in your mind, I'm here to tell you what you're about to face. Yeah, and like the most absolute drop dead beautiful girls are going to be able to find sugar daddies easier than if you're average. Or, oh, and the number of fat chicks on there is crazy. One chick's got like BBWs need a sugar daddy too. I'm like, bitch, are you crazy? You know why men go to the strip clubs? You know, they have a girlfriend to see something they don't have at home. Any dude could see a fat bitch anywhere. I'm like, hey, that's so common. Most of y'all are fat. I'm like, really? Why are you on this site? But delusions and false expectations gamed up by the approximation that you can make a lot of money very easily. During COVID, there were a lot of girls who made a lot of money with OnlyFans pages. But what's happened? All these girls are going to OnlyFans. So the competition has increased, prices have come down, and it's going to be a dumpster fire. Unless you're just very unique or you have a following already, that's gonna run out. And I guarantee you, if we go to another lockdown, the number of women who are gonna go on these sugar baby websites, the number of women who are gonna go OnlyFans, the number of women who are gonna do something strange for some change is going to dramatically increase. And I'm just saying, go ahead, go below, get 30 days to 2,500 and start making money legitimately. That's my advice to you. It's a free course to help you out. Because, you know, watching this one chick, she was talking about women. Why are women trying to align themselves with rich men instead of starting their own businesses if women are so powerful? Why aren't women starting businesses left and right? It's not in their genetic makeup. It's not in their biological imperative. Their biological imperative dictates that they pair up with a man who already has done it. That's not power. That's very submissive. That is very needy. It's very, very needy. And like I'm saying, for a man like me, you could be, I got rid of pretty chicks. I got rid of chicks with amazing sex. I need more. And y'all don't understand that because, but in time, because see, I'm on here on the YouTube, so I'm just saying what I'm saying, but life is going to hit you across the head harder than I ever could. So that's all I got for you guys. If you want to level up and you want to come out of this pandemic thing better than you went in, go below, get the corporate citizen. I teach you how to set up holding companies. I teach you how to set up operating companies. I teach you how to fund the companies. I also teach you how to start a business from scratch. All of that's down below. So with that, I'll see you guys in the next one.